What's going on, champions? Welcome back to the channel. In this video, you will discover how to buy a house for $0 down. So no money out of your pocket, no down payment. If this is what you're looking for, you are at the right spot. Be sure to watch till the very end because these 5 to 6 tips that I'll be dropping in this video will blow your mind, especially number 5. Number 5 will blow your mind. I mean, trust me, a lot of people have not heard of this strategy before, and I'm not selling you anything, right? I'm bringing you great information that will help you if you are looking to purchase a home right now and you do not have the money for down payment. Some of these you may have heard before, but we're gonna get into it. We're gonna unpack it. But number 5 is going to blow your mind. Before we dive into it, if this is your first time stopping by this channel, welcome. Consider subscribing now to join this amazing community to stay informed on the helpful tips for your financial wellness and success. And one more thing, give this video a thumbs up and share with other people to help them get this information quicker. People deserve the financial empowerment as well. Let's jump right into this. Let's cut the chase, right? Benefits of the $0 down payment. When it comes to the $0 down payment, what are the pros, right? What are the benefits? What do you stand to gain? The first thing you stand to gain, I gave you 2 things here in this video. So the first thing you stand to gain is extra cash in the bank. So when you have no money coming out of pocket for your down payment, when you're basically having someone pay your down payment, that leaves you with more money in the bank that you could use or that you can use for emergencies or for maintenance issues when you purchase the home. There's always going to be unexpected things that come up. Now, this leaves you with more cash in the bank and peace of mind. Number 2, the second thing you gotta understand when it comes to the benefits of the $0 down payment is you are going to have a bigger mortgage interest write-off. This is if you are not taking the standard deduction. Now you got to talk to your accountant or your CPA about this. So this is very important and this is a benefit. Okay, now that you know, let's talk about the very first loan that you can use to get the $0 down payment, and that's the USDA loan. So this loan is basically a government funded loan, and with this loan you have to live in specified USDA rural areas, and there are certain requirements for this loan when it comes to your income. You cannot make more than 115% of your median income for the county or the city that you live in. So this is something you got to keep in mind. So this loan was designed for the low to moderate income earners. So if this applies to you, you really got to take advantage of this because there's also no mortgage insurance included with this loan, and this loan product will pay your down payment. So this is very key for those of you who do not mind living in the rural areas or the specified rural areas. So you got to check out this USDA loan. The next one is also a government funded loan. So this applies to active duty servicemen or service women, right? So if you are an active duty service member or you are a veteran or a spouse of a veteran, you can take advantage of this. This is the VA loan, right? And this loan comes with 0 down, 100% financing. And recently they removed the limit. So that means you can even purchase higher priced homes. With this comes what we call the certificate of eligibility, or what is called the certificate of eligibility in order to qualify for this. So you have to, like I said, you have to be a member of the military, or you may have, you know, served in the military and you are under good standing, or a spouse of a military service member. So this loan does not have the mortgage insurance. However, there's a funding fee that gets tacked or rolled into the loan. So you gotta pay attention to some of those numbers. But the thing is, you still do not have to come to the table with any money if you have the right entitlement, if your entitlement is in good shape. So you got to talk to your lender about your personal, you know, profile, you know, your credit score. You got to talk about, you know, what your eligibility is, and that is shown in your certificate of eligibility. But once you are eligible for this, chances are that you can get 100% VA financing. So you may be wondering, what if I am not a veteran? What if I have not served in the military, or I'm not a spouse of a veteran? What else is available to me out there? That takes us to number three. So number three is the DPA program. What is the DPA? Down Payment Assistance Program. Now, this could be a loan or a grant, but there are so many, you know, programs out there, depending on where you live, mostly funded by the government, you know, to states and counties, to help people that fall under specific umbrella to purchase a home. And it provides down payment for these people. And most times these DPA loans kind of roll in or service, or basically are classified as a second mortgage. So you gotta, you know, tap into some of these resources. Check in with your city, check in with your county, and check in with your state for the down payment assistance programs. So they're out there for those who qualify. You gotta talk to them, see what you qualify for, and take advantage of this. But like I said, there are rules, there are requirements, and there are parameters around these products for $0 down payment. Okay, so what if this does not apply to you? It's gotta be something out there, right? This number four, right? This very strategy is one that's known as seller financing by some people, but I like to call it owner financing. Now, this can come in different forms, and this falls under the creative financing. Basically, with this one, you could deploy multiple strategies. You just have to know how to negotiate with the owner of the property that you are interested in. Most times, the common forms that we see are the rent to own or lease to own. So you could get into a lease to own agreement with the owner, to where you, you know, basically take up the maintenance, and you take up the, you know, paying for the upkeep of the property, and you rent the property for a certain amount of time, after which, based upon what the agreement is, you get to own the property. Now, sometimes you can negotiate something when you're coming to the table with no money down. Something you can negotiate is an interest-only payment for X amount of years, let's say for 5 years, meaning that any payment you've made will only go towards interest and not principal pay down. Then after, say, year number five, anything after that now goes towards your principal pay down and your interest. So you just got to be on the lookout. Most people who get this type of product typically have bad credit or no credit. So if your credit is challenged, you know, chances are that this will work well for you. You just got to find a seller who's interested in this, and you talk to them. Well, if you are renting a home right now, you may want to talk to your current landlord and see if your landlord is open to doing an owner financing, especially if you love the home and you love the location and you enjoy living in the home and you see yourself there for a few more years. This is very important. So let's talk about the next one, number five. Number five is also very important. Like I said, number five will blow your mind, because this is a new strategy that has gained some steam. In fact, I'm gonna show you a demo here. You know, fractional ownership, that's what it's called, right? This might sound a little bit woozy or, you know, just confusing, but let's unpack this for a second. So there are companies that have, you know, propped up or come up, you know, they're basically springing up right now to help home buyers or people who are looking to purchase homes, first-time home buyers, but they cannot come up with a 20% down payment. These companies will take some type of ownership. It's almost like a futures contract in your home, to where they take a percentage. They give you the down payment. Let's say they front you 10% or 20% down payment, and they're going to tap into the equity in your home. So let's say the home goes up in value. The investment for them is to tap into whatever appreciation or gain that you have in your home. Now, this could be a little confusing, but I promise I'm going to show you some, you know, some companies that are doing this right now. You just kind of get a feel of how it works. And these could be specific to certain types of people, but let's dive into this demo. You're gonna really like this. So this is one of the companies, right, called Landed. Again, I'm not selling anything. These guys are not promoting this channel yet, not yet. So I'm just bringing you helpful tips, right? And this is not me endorsing these companies. Do your own research. I'm just bringing you examples. There are lots of companies out there doing this right now. So do your research, talk to your agents, and make sure you are getting the right company for the need that you have. Okay, so Landed is an example of a company that provides down payment assistance or down payment for essential workers. So if you are an essential worker, a school teacher, a municipal employee, a physician assistant, firefighter, school counselor, you can tap into this resource, right, for down payment. So Landed is one of them. And the other one that also provides a better way or assistance for home buyers, prospective home buyers, is Unison. So Unison is one, according to them, they said now there is a smarter, better way to own homes. We call it co-investing. So they co-invest with you, but there's always something to gain. Like I said, these guys are pretty much like your co-owners, you know, they're like your co-partners in the home because they front you some money, but there is a catch for them. There's a catch. Then there's a Loftium. So Loftium is a very interesting one. This company has been known for fronting people the down payment money. They give you the down payment money and you really, you know, are not held to so much, you know, restrictions or whatever. There's no high payment or anything like that, according to some people's experiences. I haven't used them before, but with Loftium, they give you the down payment money and the requirements from them. There's no payment to them. The requirement from them is that you have to rent out a room in your home on Airbnb. So you have to rent out a room in your property on Airbnb. That is the requirement. And you know, that just helps them make money off of you on that property. And I'm not 100%, but you have to do your research to make sure that it's in your market. It may not be in every market yet, but you gotta tap into that. So I've given you three, you know, examples of companies that are doing the fractional ownership, but this is a trend that we're seeing right now when it comes to home ownership. So fractional home ownership. Now, number six is just a bonus, right? Down payment gifts. You can ask for down payment gifts from your friends and your family members. Again, no one is saying go out there and start begging for money, but if you have rich uncles or rich aunties, you know, you can always tap in. You know, there's nothing wrong with asking for help. You may be able to, you know, pay them, you know, through other services, legal services in the future, or maybe, you know, just write them a thank you letter and that's it. But down payment gift is always a thing that you can tap into if you do not have the money to pay for a home, to put down for a home. Okay, now that we've explored all of these strategies or all of these ways to get the $0 down, what's the catch? Like, what is the, we can't just sit here singing kumbaya, making it sound like there's no side, you know, there's no pitfalls or no cons to this. So there are some pitfalls or some, you know, disadvantages of the zero dollar down payment. And some of them, the key ones that I highlighted here are ones that you should take account of. Take these into account. Higher mortgage rate. So you're going to have a higher mortgage payment, right? Because $0 down, that means you're going to have a bigger monthly payment to your lender. So you got to make sure that you have enough income to cover the higher mortgage rate or the higher mortgage amount at the end of the month. Then you also have the higher closing cost. So you gotta make sure that you are getting some type of seller concession, asking the seller to pay for this, or getting some lender credits to offset the higher closing cost. But this is something you have to understand. Some of these loan products, or these products we've talked about, may tack on the closing cost onto the loan. So you can take advantage of that as well. Then there's something called the mortgage insurance. The VA loan does not have the mortgage insurance if you're 100% financed, and you know, the USDA loan does not have that as well. So again, this is something you have to know. There are some setbacks or some drawbacks with the $0 down payment, but it doesn't mean you shouldn't do it, especially if you have the money to cover the payment and you see yourself staying in that property for a while. You can't just buy it and you're up and leave the next year. You gotta see yourself being there for at least a few years in order to maximize the benefits of the $0 down payment or the no down payment loans. So let me know your thoughts about this in the comment section below. And if you've gained one or two insights from this video, be sure to let us know in the comment section, and be sure to let me know by giving this video a thumbs up. Be sure to subscribe if you haven't done that as well, and see you in the next one. Stay safe, and thank you for watching.